first part of the episode. Oh, okay. That's pretty funny. So yeah, we're playing Everybody's Gone to the Rapture again, back again with episode 2. First episode, we kind of discovered what the game was about, and now we're back again. Ooh. So there's some cool little things here. And I just literally plugged out the plug for this remote, which was not the best idea in the world. But yeah, we are going to go outside over here, I guess. Run forward, because to obviously lengthen the story. And it's chapter 2 of this game. We scored Jeremy's chapter. Now we're moving on. We can't really get a running start here, can we? Oh, why are we not getting faster? What's the deal with that? You know the easy get faster? I'm not getting faster. It's creepy. Is that not the controls? Yeah, hold R2 to build speed. That's literally what I'm doing. I'm not building any speed. I'm not sucking diesel. I should be. Instead I'm going very slowly. Okay. Wendy, yes, we're in chapter 2. Wendy. Aha, we're back into the roar of it. Grand. This is what I'm talking about. Sorry, I get really frustrated about those sort of things. I'm sure you all do as well when you walk really slowly and you can't get faster. That annoys me a lot. So, yeah, chapter 1, Jeremy, we got that out of the way. Pretty stunning conclusion, really, with the death of... must have been the death of Jeremy, really. The priest guy. I don't know what his name is. But yeah, this is a deadly disease, I guess you'd be the only really word for it. And the music, I tell you, is great. But the one thing I gotta love about this game, over the music, over the actual lovely graphics, over the gameplay, which is eh, and over the weird lighty thing, the characters and the story. This is genuinely actually very good character work here. Generally, I'm really enjoying the characters. And the special thing is, I don't even know what they look like. So they've pretty much made conveying characters without any use of, any actual use of, you know, the appearance. They've really done it, and it's amazing, really, what they've done with this. It's class, it's a class idea as well. I really appreciate it. Still haven't discovered out who I am, but... could just be Cameron Man. Do this again. Wait. Get the wall. Bookshelf. There we go.
You do look ever so drawn this morning.
That bloody dog kept me awake. And there was that thing in the sky. The radio says it was an electrical storm, but I don't know what it was. This morning, I found some dead birds in the garden.
I'm sorry to hear that. I wonder if it might have had something to do with the atmospheric conditions.
Why, Stephen will probably know. I'll give him a call in a bit.
Wendy, I've popped around because we've had some incidents with some of the more elderly residents. Mrs. Bouton has, well, vanished, for want of a better word. Wandered off somewhere, no doubt. I thought I'd best check and see you're all right.
The council are talking about a flu epidemic.
Yes, well, I'm not sure it's flu as such. But no headaches... nosebleeds, no joint pains or digestive issues.
Dr. Wade, I'm as fit as a fiddle. Go and find some real sick people to look after. And if you see that son of mine, tell him that his mother's looking for him.
Anyways, guys, that was something. Out the back door, I guess. Where to? Go towards possible sound, I guess. Anything possibly over here, maybe? Whew. Nothing really. Binoculars, I guess. You're really into that sort of thing. A little tea. Gotta imagine Wendy living here. I'm pretty sure it's Wendy's house. So, yeah. Let's go. Vámonos. Let's see. Go, let's go, let's go, let's go.
Going away, Amanda?
Oh, just for a few days, yeah. First thing in the morning. Don't want the kids to catch this flu if it's going round.
It's probably that Father Jeremy spreading it around while he tries to bully everyone into donations for the summer fete.
Seems very quiet in the village, actually, Wendy. Not much bullying to be done.
Oh, Father. I didn't know you were here.
Clearly. Listen, I came up here to tell Amanda that we've had some vandalism in the village. Must be a teenage thing. Tagging, I think they call it. Someone's painting all over doors and things.
Little vandals. Well, I'll tell Neil to make sure we're properly locked up when we go.
A good man like my Eddie gone. And these thugs and yobs running around defacing property. He gave everything to his country, and look what he got in return, nothing but an early death.
He had a good life, Wendy.
He had a short life. I look to my birds, Father. Lives lived unencumbered, free and simple. That's as God meant things to be.
Alright then. I have the sort of feeling that's going here. I remember whoever's house this is. Let's step inside. So interesting. So Jeremy is around and he must be like, you know, friends, I guess. But it's strange to see that sort of behavior. Should I get here? I can hear the radio from there. There we go.
Every computer in the observatory has set itself to 6:07 a.m. June 6th, 1984.
Huh.
I don't understand what that means.
That is weird. It's such a mystery. It's really becoming like, oh my god, like strange events are really taking place. And it's very interesting to kind of piece them together. I have no idea, but maybe you guys have a better idea, so comment below. Don't put it in the chat, but after the video is made, you can put it in the comments. Stressy, don't put it in the chat, because I will not be able to see it after I make the video. And I will not get to the chat at the moment, because I'm concentrating on the gameplay, so hopefully it doesn't make me sound like a prick saying that, but, you know, just take that into account. I'm going in the back. The work shed? The AY? What's this? This is some book about something else. I can't read it. I think she's obsessed with birds, Wendy's. Could be interesting. Let's see this. Weird. They kind of brought me to that random shed for no reason. So head down here and see what's up. Also, there's a comment below if you want to see more stuff like this. Again, I'm getting this game for free and it's a great deal. And PSN is nice enough to be offering this with their PlayStation Network. So again, I'll play more games like this, you know, I like these kind of games with the kind of like, you know, the Telltale sort of style. So I really want to get into those Telltale games, so in the future we'll be trying to get those games because they're just really nice to watch. And I guess engaging is a full story. Obviously there'll be longer videos because, you know, you want to get the chapter in there or the part. So these parts are definitely longer, 45 minutes. I don't want to edit these ones then. Easy enough for me to make, and they're also just really fun and they feel kind of interactive with the way, you know, you can decide what you would have done in that situation or piecing together a story. So I really like them. These sort of games. I don't think I can go that way. There's no way over. Sorry, it's out of the quarantine zone, which kind of sucks. I would like to go that way. To have gone that way, sorry. Where's my English gone? Room. You know what I meant, though. A little picnic, actually. It's kind of nice. Quite pleasant. I guess I'm gonna have to go up here. Aha! Little pathway, I see. Yes.
It got as far as the Haverton substation before we cut the lines. The interchange there just started dialing numbers at random.
And the symptoms you're seeing match those we've been tracking here.
Sickness, headaches, nosebleeds, eventual hemorrhage, then just light, whatever the hell that means.
Then we've got to stop it before it finds another way out of the valley. Clive, you've got to order a strike.
What?
An airstrike. We have to kill it.
No. No, I don't agree. We've quarantined the valley, we've cut the lines, it's contained.
What if you're wrong? Are you happy to have that on your conscience?
Stephen. I said it's contained.
Uh-huh. Pretty crazy. Let's go this way. So they're cutting the lines to this Haverton place, I guess. And they're on a widespread attack. It seems too late in my opinion. But we'll see. We'll see what happens. Maybe it's too late and, you know, things have gone wrong already. Or, you know, caused widespread damage to the area. Should be an issue from them, I guess. We'll see.
Terry called this morning. Said there was a problem with Arby. Said he couldn't get through to the vet, so I said I'd come round and take a look.
There's a lot of dead birds today. More here, too, poor little things. I've been trying to get hold of Steve and he always knows what to do.
Got round here and no sign of either of them.
With any luck, the stupid creature will have run under a car. It's probably rabies.
Go.
Come on, boy.
Come on.
Harvey! Come on, boy!
Harvey!
Harvey!
Push it. I told you it would get stuck.
Should have just taken the car. This was a stupid idea.
Moving here was a stupid idea. And I told you, Barbara said they blocked the roads. You go and look then.
Wait, is that Harvey? Harvey? Harvey!
Harvey! Here, boy! Come here, boy!
Harvey the dog, I guess. Oh, this is good, man.
Wendy, I'm married. You have to stop this.
He's still sweet on you, Elizabeth.
He left. It's too late.
You loved each other long before she came along. It's just about making things as they should be.
Wendy, no.
It's not like you won't bump into each other anyway. One drink, what can that hurt?
One drink, maybe.
Oh, one drink, wonderful.
Grief, Wendy, you'll catch your death.
They're all dead, Father. All of my birds.
Here. Take my jacket.
I tried to be a good woman. A Christian woman. But I've been proud.
Just as the Lord forgave you, so also should you. What matters is we try our best. God sees that. Come back to the village with me.
I'm not so far from Stevens now. I need to find my son. It's what Eddie would have done.
Yes. I suppose it is. I'll say a prayer for you.
Thank you, Father. She loved you, you know, Mary. You helped her. I'm sorry if I judged you harshly.
It doesn't matter now. It's late. You should find a place to sleep. I'm sure when the sun comes up, everything will seem better.
Everything might seem better, yeah. hope to God it seems better. After this. This. Place. Great presence around me, isn't there?
Did they think they were going?
I think they must have thought they could walk out along the line.
Well, there won't be any more trains now.
You're a callous bastard, Stephen.
Just pragmatic, Howard. Did you say there's a working phone in the junction box?
Holy shit. This thing crashed. Well, obviously, of course. Still. Fucking hell, look at it. No, that's not open. The open box. What's going on there, though? Pretty crazy.
My shoes.
Box.
I lost my shoes, sir. There's arches on the green. They take my shoes, sir.
Howard? Howard Lantham! You open the door this instant, young man.
I lost my shoes.
Now get up. Get up.
I lost my shoes.
What on earth are you doing here, Howard?
Stephen. He told me to stay in case Lizzie phoned.
Stephen, where is he?
What are you doing with those birds?
Concentrate, Howard. Where's Stephen?
He said he couldn't help them. He took my shoes so I'd stay.
Listen to me, Howard Lantham. You find your shoes and you get to the village. Find Father Jeremy. He'll give you some soup or something. Be off with you.
Where are you going?
I'm gonna find my son. Then I'm going to ask him what on earth he thinks he's doing.
What is he doing? He's a madman. That's what it is. Wendy's son caused the problem in the first place, so that's pretty crazy. Pretty damn crazy. Go this way.
fancy seeing you here. Is everything all right, my dear?
Oh, I'm sorry. I'm all right. It's just... Robert.
That man doesn't deserve you. I know everybody thinks I'm just a mithering old busybody, but someone has to say what everyone else is thinking. We both know that this marriage, it's not how things are supposed to be.
Are you talking about me and Robert? Or is this really about Stephen and Kate?
I suppose it is. I have to accept it. I know, but she doesn't belong here. You see that, don't you? There's a place for people, and this isn't hers. Oh. But I'm not talking about the colour of her skin. Don't look at me like that.
Oh, shit.
What they do up there, it's not natural. There are some things we're not supposed to understand. I don't like her. And I don't like how Stephen is around her. He was a better man when he was with you.
That's pretty crazy. Crazy. Anyways, hello David, hello Angel, I think, Chavez, whoever there's, Angle, Chavez, let's go. Sorry, there are just people in the chat if you're wondering. Let's go, we're here. Where the hell are we going? Wendy's house? Sure. Where did he come from? Quite creepy, isn't it?
Wendy? Wendy, wake up.
Eddie, is that you?
No, it's me. It's Frank.
Oh, Frank. The door was open. I didn't think Graham would mind.
I'm sure he won't. What are you doing here?
Looking for Stephen, but I just...
Ah, Zero Blade, 322. Hello.
The door was open.
Oh.
You listen to the radio. I thought I heard him on the radio before.
Shout out.
All over the valley.
Here is a shout out.
This is some abstract thing. Whatever came down into the tower has got out. They've quarantined the whole valley.
It's right here in the observatory.
It's out in the world. It's adapting and spreading. Do you understand?
No, we can't turn it away.
What's he talking about?
I don't again. If he's on the radio, we can try and reach him on the CB. You go to Stephen's house, and if I get hold of him, I'll tell him to come and find you.
All right then, Zero Blood, there's your shout out, bro. Is that Jan? Yes or no? Your name, Jan? the fuck are we? Alright, shit. Let's go over here. Zero blade equals Yan. No?
There's something in the observatory with me. I can feel it reaching out to me. When it's close, I'm overcome with the most profound sense of loneliness.
That's enough. That shit. That's very helpful to our journey here. Moment. It's very freaking helpful, mate. I much appreciate it. Now, what to do next? I trip around the garden. Jack shit to see here, so let's leave. What have you gone, mate? Fucking crazy, mate. What the fuck is that shouting? Screaming. What the fuck? This is like twisted. Nice weight though. In the garage. Respect it though. Props. You're not going anywhere. That's for sure.
Jesus! Come on, not now. Jesus, come on, you bastard. Start, you bastard. Come on.
All right then. I can go inside if you want to. If you want me to.
Stephen! Stephen, are you here? It's your mother. Answer me! Stephen!
Thank you. Where is Stephen?
Stephen, where is Kate? Are you here?
Doesn't seem to be working. Oh shit.
Stephen? I can hear the planes. It's the government coming to rescue us. You can come out now. It's all gonna be all right. I can hear the jets coming. It's like when Eddie came home. It's like your dad coming home again.
Let's go this way. Weird. Same sort of sequence we had when the last chapter ended. So this may be the end of this chapter. We'll see. See where this goes. Frank. Alright guys, that is the end of this chapter. Frank is the next start of chapter 3, which is part 3, coincidentally, of this series. Thank you guys for watching, and I'll see you next time. Bye guys.